Hello students and Sai Ram to everyone. Yes, coming to our math subject, chapter 1, numbers. So today we are going to do revision part, okay, revise all the concepts that you have learned till now. Okay, so there were many concepts what you have learned, so all the concepts we are going to revise today. Now, what are the different topics we have learned? We have learned the different concepts, that is counting up to crores, the Indian and the international number system, how to write the numbers in Indian and international number system, their place value and face value, expanded and short form, comparison between Indian and international number system, that is what is the difference between the two, the predecessor and successor. Then also we have learned about the comparison, how to compare two numbers, and how, that is about ordering of numbers, that is in ascending and descending order. Then we have also learned how to form the largest and the smallest number in the topic, that is juggling of numbers. And also we have learned how to round off the numbers to the nearest 10, 100 and thousands. Now let's quickly revise all the topics once again, one by one. Okay, now first topic is counting up to crores. Now students, in the first lesson, in the first online lesson, we have learned how to write the numbers, that is by putting commas, separate the periods of ones, thousands, lakhs and crores, and how to write the numbers accordingly up to crores, correct? Now see here the number, that is here it is 3,85,46,213. So once a number is given, I have taught you how to put commas and separate the periods accordingly to their period, that is once from the right side when we start, we have the ones, tens and hundred, then we have the thousands period, then we have the lakhs period, and then the crores period. So accordingly we put the commas and then read a number. Now in the next topic, that is Indian numeral system, we have learned, that is according to the Indian numeral system, from the starting, that is from the right side when we start, we have the ones column, tens, hundred. Yes, this is grouped into one period. Then we have the thousands period. In that we have thousand and 10,000. Then we have the lakhs period, that is lakh and 10 lakh. And we have the crores and the 10 crores. So now when we write this number, 38,24,05,765. Now according to the Indian numeral system, if you remember, I have taught you that from the right side when you start, from the first three digits you put a comma, then after every two digits you go on putting a comma. That is according to the Indian numeral system. Now this number can be read as 38,24,05,765. So according to the Indian numeral system, from the right side when you start, three digits you put a comma, then after every two digits you go on putting a comma. Okay, now when you come to the international numeral system, now in the international numeral system, in the first period you have, that is ones, so you have the ones, tens and hundred, the same as how we have for the Indian numeral system. Then in the Indian numeral system we had thousands, ten thousands, and then we had the lakhs, but here according to the international numeral system we have hundred thousands, that is in the thousands period we have three places, and then again million, 10 million, and then 100 million. Okay, now suppose if you have a number 3,86,45,39. Suppose if you have this number, according to this international numeral system, the first three digit you put a comma, then again after every three digit, But in the Indian system, you had after every 2 digits. But here, according to the international system, you have after every 3 digits. So in the ones period, you have 3 numbers. In the thousands, you have 3 digits. And again, in the millions, you have 3 digits. Now, while reading a number, you will read this number as 3,864,539. Okay, while reading a number, you will read it in 3,864,539. This is according to the international numeral system. Now, based on this, we had also learned about the place value and face value. Now, what is the place value? Place value, you all know that it states the position of a digit of a given number, whereas the face value describes the value of the digit. Now, let us take an example here. One number is given, that is 2, 4, 5, 6. Now, if I have to write the place value of this number, that is the place value of the number in the ones place is 6. So, the place value of the number in the 6, it is remains the same as it is in ones place, 6 itself. Now, the number 5 is in tens place. So, the place value of the number 5 becomes 50 since it is in tens place. Now, the place value of the number 4, that is which is in hundreds place, is 400. Now the 2 is in thousands place, so the place value of the number 2 in thousands place is 2000. So when you write the place value of the number in thousands place is 2000, the place value of the number 4 in hundreds place is 400, the place value of the number tens place 5, that is 50, whereas the place value of the number 6 in ones place is 6. Now, if I ask you the face value of these numbers, it is nothing but the value of the digits. So, when I say the face value remains the same, it does not change. So, if I say the number 2, 4, 5, 6, okay, so the face value of the numbers 6 remains 6 itself, 5 it remains 5 itself, 4 it remains 4 itself, and 2 it remains 2 itself. So the place value of the number states the position of the digit, that is in which place it is, whether it is in tens place, hundreds place, thousands place, or 10,000s place, whereas the face value of the number does not change, it remains the same. Okay, now coming to the expanded and short form, that is short form is also known as the standard form of a number. Now this we have already done this also. Now suppose the same example, if I take, that is the number 2456, that is 2456. If I take the same number, same example, if I want to write this number in expanded form, how will I write this? You will write, expanded form is always written as the number as a sum of the place values. Now what we already learned, the place value, the place value of the number 2, it is in thousands place, so it is 2000. The place value of the number 4 is in hundreds place, so I will write it as 400. Now 5 is in tens place, so it is 50, and 6 is in ones place, so it is 6. So when you write it in expanded form, you will write it as the number as a sum of the place value. Sum means you will put the plus sign in the middle and write this number in expanded form. Now this, when we write only the number, this number, that means it is, the number is said to be in the standard form, or it is said to be in the short form. Now suppose if the number is given in the expanded form and you have to write the number, so I will write the number as 2456. So when I write this only the number, it is said that the number is written in short form or it is written in standard form. So understood what is the difference, expanded form and short form? Yes. Now coming to the next topic, we're just having a quick look at whatever the topics we have done. Now, comparison between Indian and international system of numeration. You have already learned about the Indian system. You have already learned about the international system, how to write the numbers, how to write it in number names. Now, what is the difference? The difference, I have already told you, you can see the difference in ones period in the, according to the Indian system. In the ones period, you have three places, that is thousands. Ones period has three places, that is ones, tens and hundred. Then thousands, in that you have thousand and 10,000. Then you have lakhs, lakh and 10 lakh. And then crores again has two places each. Whereas in the international system, all the periods have three places, right? When you start from the right side, in the ones period, you have ones, tens and hundred. Then in the thousands period, again, you will have three places, that is thousand, 10,000 and 100,000. And then we have millions, 10 millions and then 100 millions. Now, what is the second difference? Starting from the extreme right, put commas after the third, fifth and seventh digits. That is our first three digits and then after every two digits. And in the international system, starting from the extreme right, put commas after the third digit, sixth digit and ninth digit. That is after every three digits, third digits. Now, in the Indian system, when we say 1 lakh, accordingly, in the international system, it is 100 thousands. In the Indian system, when we say 10 lakh, it is 1 million in the international system. When you draw the place value and write the place value of that numbers, automatically, you will come to know the difference between the Indian and the international system. When we write 1 crore, according to the Indian system, it is 10 million according to the international system of numeration. And when we write 10 crore, it is 100 million according to the international system of numeration. Okay, students? So whenever you write the numerals, just write the place, draw a place value chart and then write the numbers. It will be easy to understand. Now, coming to the next topic, what we have learned is predecessor and successor. Now, what is predecessor and successor? Now, the successor of a number is obtained by adding 1 to it. Now, successor means the after number. Okay, that is when we add one more number. So, see, this example is given here 1,23,445. So, 445, when you add 1 to it, you will get the number, that is the after number, that is 1,23,446. Now, the predecessor number means before number. So, when do we get the before number? When you subtract 1 from the given number. Now, see the example given here. It is given as, it is given according to the international system. So, you will read this number as 34,213,211. So, when you subtract 1, you will get 34,213,210. Okay, so what is successor? Successor is nothing but the after number what you write, and predecessor is the before number. Okay, so let us take a quick look on the next topic, that is comparison of numbers. Now, what is comparison? How do you compare a numbers? Now, when you must remember that when we did this topic, I already told you, when you compare any two numbers, always you have to keep two rules in mind, that is two points in mind. Now, what is that 2 points? The first point is, a number which has more digits is always greater than the other number. Here one example I have shown you. Here, see, in the first number is 29,432 and in the second number is 9,807. Now, 29,432, here it is a 5-digit number, whereas 9,807, it is a 4-digit number. So, according to the first point, when we say a number which has more digits is greater. So, obviously, the 29,432 is greater than 9,807. Now, what is the second point while comparing the numbers? Suppose if you have the same number of digits, okay? When the two numbers have the same number of digits, start comparing from the extreme left. Now, suppose if, let me give you one example. Let me show you one example. The highest place value. Suppose one example I'll take as 38,400. and 16. Then here I'll have 38,146. Now here in this 38,000, 38,000, both are same. So when the extreme left start comparing the number, both the numbers are same, that is 38,000. Now come to the next number. Here it is 400 and here it is 100. Now 4 is greater than 1. So that means this number is greater than this number. Okay. So 38,416 is greater than 38,146. So only these two points you have to keep it in mind. The first point is a number that is the digit which has greater number of digits is always greater. But if the two numbers have the same number of digits, start comparing from the extreme left and the highest place value, and then move to the right to the smaller place values. Okay. Coming to the next one, that is ordering of numbers. Ordering of numbers means that is writing the numbers in ascending and descending order. Now once you have finished with comparison of numbers, when you know how to compare a number, it becomes easy for you to write the numbers in ascending and descending order. That means when you compare a number, you come to know which is small and which is big. So accordingly, in the ascending number, when we write from small number to big number, and in the descending order, we write from big number to small number. So when we arrange the numbers in an increasing order, that is from small to big, it is called as ascending order. And when the numbers are arranged in decreasing order, they are known as descending orders. Okay. Now the next topic, what we had learned is about the juggling of numbers. Now what is juggling of numbers? Here 5 digits are given. Juggling means you have to form the largest and the smallest number using these numbers given. Now suppose if you remember, now from these numbers you now know which is the bigger number. Now while forming the largest number, start writing the digits, the larger digit first, that is 7, 6, 5, 3, 2. Now you have formed a 5 digit largest number. Now while forming the smallest number, you will write the small number first, that is 2, 3, 5, 6, and 7. This is how you form the largest and the smallest number from the given digits. Okay. Now also you must remember that if in the digit a 0 is given, suppose one example I'll give you, suppose if the digit is given as 5, 0, 3, 2, and 4, and you have to form the 5 digit largest and smallest number. Now how to form a 5 digit largest and smallest number? Now while forming the largest number, you know that you'll write the largest number, that is the biggest number first, 5, 4, 3, 2, 0, correct? From the big number to small number. Now the same thing while forming a smallest number, again I'll tell you, when you write, you're not supposed to write 0 at the first place. Why? Because if you write 0 at the first place, it becomes, while forming a number, it becomes a 4 digit number. But here you have to form the smallest 5 digit number. So what you will do is, you will write 2 first, then 0, then 3, 4, and then 5. So this is how you form the smallest 5 digit number. Okay, hope you all must have understood again what we are doing. Now coming to the next topic, that is rounding of the numbers. Now for rounding of the number to the nearest 10, 100, 1,000, 10,000, there are some rules again which you have to remember. Now the what is the first rule? There are two rules again for this, that is two points what you have to keep it in mind. If the number you are rounding is followed by 5, 6, 7, 8 or 9, round the number up. Okay, I'll show you an example. Now, example, suppose 38 here it is given. Now, it is followed by the number 8. So, what you will do is, you will round the number upwards. That is towards tens. That is 38 is rounded off. When you round it off to the nearest 10, it becomes 40. Now, the second point is, if the number you are rounding is followed by 0, 1, 2, 3 or 4, round the number downwards. If you want to round up the number to the nearest 10, suppose now 33, the number it is followed by 3, the second number. So when you round up the number to the nearest 10, it is rounded off to 30. Now just see this example here, 38,456. Now suppose if I want to round off this number to the nearest 10, 100 and 1000. The same number we will take. Let us take a first number, 38,456. If you want to round off this number to the nearest 10, when you want to round off to the nearest 10, you will see the number in the ones place. Okay. Now the number in the ones place, for what is the first rule? That is, if this number in the ones place, it is followed by 5, 6, 7 or 8, you will round off the number upside. That means to this 5, you will add 1. So when you round off this number to the nearest 10, it becomes 38,400. 5 plus 1 will become 6 and in the ones place, you will put a 0. Got it? So if it is found, again I'm telling you, repeating, when the number is followed by 5, 6, 7 or 8, you will add 1 to the number in the tens place. If you want to round off the number to the nearest 10. Now the same number, if you want to round off to the nearest 100, let us take the same number, 3, 8, 4, 5, 6. Now the number you have to round off it to the nearest 100. Okay. So which number you will see? You will see the number in the tens place. Okay. Again, what does the rule say? The rule says that if the number is followed by 5, 6, 7, 8 or 9, you will add the 1 to the number in the hundreds place. So when you round off this number, it will become 38,005. 4 plus 1 is 5. In the tens place and in the ones place, you will put 0. Why? Because we are rounding it off to the nearest 100. Okay. So understood the rule? Now coming to the third point. When you have to round off this number to the nearest 1000. Now let us take the same number. If I take the same number, it will be better for you to understand. So 3, 8, 4, 5, 6. Now you have to round off it to the nearest 1000. 1, 10, 100, 1000. So which number will you see now? You will see the number in the hundreds place. When you want to round off the number to the thousands place, you will see the number in the hundreds place. Now the rule is, the number is not more than 5. That is, it is less than 5. So the second rule, that is second point you have to remember, that is you have to move downwards. Now you will not add 1 to this number in the thousands place. This number in the thousands place will remain the same. But in the hundreds place, tens place and ones place, you will put a 0. So when you round off a number, it becomes the number 38,000. Understood? Yes, students? Yes. Okay, now hope you must have understood all the topics what I have explained it today. We have revised again today, okay? Now based on this, I want you all to do FA1 project. Okay, I'll be explaining you about this project. Now, you have to do this project in a paper. Okay, now how to do this, I'll be explaining it to you. And just write your name, roll number, standard on a piece of paper and just submit it when the school reopens. Okay, now before doing this project, first read it thoroughly how to do it. Okay, now what you have to do is you have to write any 5 date of birth of your relatives, like your father, mother, sibling. Sibling means your brother or sister, grandparents, friends, any 5 date of birth. From that, what you have to do is you have to form the smallest and the largest possible number using all the digits from each date of birth. Now see here, first is, and also write the number name both in Indian and international system of numeration. Now see, one example is given here. Suppose if your date of birth is 14th of December, 14-12-2010. Okay, so first is the date, next is the month, and next is the year. So you have to remove this space and put all the numbers together. So when you put all the numbers together, that is 14-12-2010, that is 2010. When you put all these numbers together, you will get this number, that is 14-12-2010. That is this number, you have removed all the space and you have put it together. Now this is your number. Okay, now from this number you have to make the smallest number. Now we already learned how to make a smallest number, correct? So the first smallest number is 1. So you'll write 1, then 2 zeros are there, 0, then again 2, 1 number is there, so write 1 1. The next smallest number is 2, so you will write 2 times 2, and the next number is 4, and put the commas according to the Indian system, that is 3-digit, 2-digit and 2-digit. Now this same number you have to write it in number names according to the Indian system. So how will you write? That is 1s, 10s, 100, 1000, 10,000, lakh, 10 lakh and crore. So when you write, this number is written as 1,11,224. Now this same number you have to write it in international number. That is, when you write it in according to the international number, 3 digits, you will put a comma, then you will write this as 10,11,224. Now this is about, after forming the first, you will form the smallest number, put the comma according to the Indian system, then write the number numeral in Indian system. Then what you have to do is the same number you will form the largest number. Now the largest number, you know how to form 4, 2, 2, 1 and then 1, 0, 0. Then you will write the number name according to the Indian system, and then again you will put the commas according to the international system, and then write the number name according to the international system. So understood how to do this project? First write your date of birth of whoever's date of birth you are taking, without removing, that is after removing the space and the line and all, you will write the date of birth. First write this, form the smallest number, put the commas, write it in the Indian numeral system, then again write it in international numeral system, then form the largest number, then write, put the commas according to the Indian system, then write the number numeral in Indian system, then again put the commas according to the international system, and write the number numeral in international, according to the international system. So understand this, you have to do it on a paper. Write your name, roll number you can use last year's, then write your name, standard, divisions, and once the school reopens we'll be collecting your project. Okay, now along with this FA1 project, you also have to solve the assignment questions which have been given to you. You have to do it on a paper or in a book and solve all the 15 questions which is given to you, and then you have to submit that assignment answers also once the school reopens. Okay, so we'll meet you after the vacation. So happy vacation, students. Till then, bye and take care.